right, our producer, Keity, wants to know, in a specific case here, when it comes to dating, is it normal because she's holding back for somebody that she hasn't even met yet?
Yes. So I'm not sure if you all heard, but like a year ago, it was revealed that Drake is, he has a collection of Birkin bags for his future girlfriend, like his future woman of his dreams. He's been collecting Birkin bags for her because he just wants to wait to give that gift to that special person. Have you guys heard that story?
All right, so can we cover this for just 1 second?
All right. Stupid.
I think we just covered it. Like, would it make it less special or more romantic if Drake finally tells you after 6 months, like, I just want to let you know, I bought these purses for you before I even met you. I have been saving it for this special woman, and it turns out you just won the Birkin lottery. Cassie?
Birkin bags are incredibly difficult to get help, like a hold of. You get taken into a special room at Hermes. You only get to see max 2 per visit, and you have to usually spend a certain amount in the store to get invited to purchase a Birkin bag. And even then, you don't get to actually request what kind you want. They come in different sizes, different colors. So hell yes, it's really nice that he is doing this, because it's not like you can walk in and be like, I'd like a mid-size Birkin in black, please. They won't do that. So to have someone thinking of you already before they even have met you to give you one of the world's rarest rich person items is really nice. It's kind of sweet, actually.
But you're not they don't know your style. They don't know anything about you. You're a mystery.
It's a Birkin bag. When you're that rich, it is a status symbol. It's not about... It's like someone collecting Bentleys. Doesn't matter if you don't like them or not. It's still a damn Bentley. You're going to take it.
So it would still be special even though it wasn't bought for you. It was just bought for someone like you.
Look at Mo. You know how much those things are worth? Some of them are upwards of 100K. I will take them.
Saying, wouldn't you want to go through the process of everything that you just said, though? Be in the stores, shopping with Drake for whatever you want. Not to mention, Birkin bags change every 6 months. So now you're going to get the old one by the time you're in his life. That's the 10-year-old Birkin bag. Like, yeah. Don't you want to be a part, like, feel personalized with
it? It's vintage, and it's not like you can't still buy the current season's Birkin. But now you have vintage Birkins, which is even better because he loves you so much already. He's already thinking about your Birkin collection.
That's the way he's going to spin it. I loved you before I met you, baby. That's why I started getting these purses for you.
Wow. Yes, because he's manifesting her into his life.
Oh, my God.
Okay. Keity, will you stop?
I can't get it. I don't get it. I've always, like, I have an aggression towards these purses and all of these things because I want my money to be on the inside of the bag, not the outside. Yeah. So could Drake just, I don't know, hold on to those millions of dollars and then when he meets me be like, lottery, jackpot, he just starts throwing $100 bills out of his pockets. Like, just save me the money. Right. I don't want the bag.
Yes, I love you so much. I've been saving all my money for you for all these years. Goes a lot further than the Birkin bag.
You just hit the husband Drake lottery.
So we're debating the wrong thing. This is not about Drake. This is about Keity. Okay, go ahead.
Sorry.
I think that what Drake is doing is cute, unless she doesn't like Birkin bags. But like Drake, who is holding out and holding on to something for his future girlfriend, I am reserving dates for my future girlfriend that I think is going to be worth it. So if I go on a date right now, it's going to be generic, right? Mm-hmm. I'm just going to go out to eat or, you know, maybe putt-putt, right? But the good dates, candle-making dates, the cooking dates, the hiking dates, the paint-and-sip dates, I want to reserve for someone I know who's going to stick around forever. Because if I go on a date with someone now and give them that special date and the memory's ruined, like if it doesn't go well, I feel like that memory of something I really wanted to do will be ruined. So why not save it for someone special? Is that weird?
I don't disagree with you. No. Like, candle making's not your first date. You got to work your way up to the honor of candle making.
It's right there above antiquing.
But yeah,
hold
like
this putt-putt 10 times before we get to that
putt. You got to punch this putt-putt card 10 times before we go candle making. I agree. Like, the first couple of dates, I mean, they should be they're preliminary dates, man. You go to Fridays in the middle of the afternoon at lunch because you're only kicking the tires for an hour. And if it works well, then you work your way up to something more special. So I got no beef with what you're doing. I think it's very different than what Drake's doing, Davi.
When I was 18, my high school boyfriend took me to putt-putt golf. It was pirate putt-putt. And I was like, this is the most romantic thing ever. Oh my God, it's so cute. We're being such dorks. And then when I met my husband, we went to Asheville, and he's like, I want to play putt-putt with you. And I felt like such a hussy because I'd done it with my ex. You know what I mean? I was like, we can't putt-putt together. I'm such a hoe. And I got my little putter, and I feel like so slutty. So I totally get what you're saying. Like, you want to reserve certain special things, because I couldn't get it out of my head that I had putt-putted with my old ex-boyfriend. And I was like, should I tell my new boyfriend? Is he going to be so mad? It felt weird.
Exactly. And like with me, when it comes to putt-putt, I can putt-putt with many people and it will not bother me. Putt-putt will still be fun. But certain things I just don't want ruined by a terrible date.
So help me out here also, Keity, as a sidebar. In the lesbian world, candle making is a wonderful time.
Well, for me, it is. I just threw out an example that I thought was great because I saw the video and I was like, oh my gosh, you can go make candles and scents together. That's so cute.
All right. So this isn't a universal lesbian celebration. Okay. Yeah. This is just a candle.
I'm straight and it sounds fun. Candle making. You have to stop.
I'm just fact finding.
What's wrong with you, man?
I'm just fact finding.
It's not. Okay. It's not at all.
Listen. It's The Bert Show.